Hi, this is Ben from the DawStudio.com, and today we're going to assemble an L2P passive line attenuator kit from DIYRE or DIYRecordingEquipment.com. As you can see, we have all of the components laid out in front of us. The L2P case, foam pad, the L2P PCB, front or input panel, and back or output panel. Two input quarter-inch jacks, two output XLR jacks, a toggle switch, resistors, and screws. First, let's divide up our resistors. We have six 2.7K resistors and two 150R resistors. Let's go ahead and get our PCB or printed circuit board set up so we can start adding components. We'll start by bending the resistors into a U-shape so they can be placed on the board. Now the board is marked with 2.7K or 150R in the respective locations of where the resistors are supposed to go. And as we place those resistors in there, we will bend back the leads so they don't fall out when it gets turned over. Now we'll put it back on the stand and solder those leads into place. Now make sure not to put too much solder or to heat it up for too long because you could ruin the board. And once that's done, we clip away the excess leads. Next we'll put on the quarter inch jacks. First we will remove the nuts and then put them in place so they line up with those six holes on that part of the board. And then you flip it over and you kind of have to use a screwdriver or a small set of pliers to bend them in place so they don't fall out and they hold themselves on there. We'll do the same thing to the second jack. And then once those are in place, we can put it down and solder all six of those contacts for each jack. Next, we will install the XLR output jacks by holding them in place there with the three leads connecting and then placing it down on the desk and soldering the contacts. Next, we'll put the switch in place. And you'll see here that we had to put the front panel on in order to get everything to line up properly. So once it's all lined up, you can put the washers and nuts on the quarter inch connectors to hold everything in place. And once all of that is connected and put together, we can flip it back over, reconnect it to the stand, and solder the leads for the switch. And when we complete the soldering, we trim the leads just like we've done before. The board is complete, everything is soldered and in place. And now it's time to put it in the case. Notice the grooves in the case that the circuit board will slide into. Also make sure that the L2P on the circuit board and the L2P on the case line up in the same direction. Now that everything is seated properly, we can put the four screws in the corners and lock that side into place. Once that's done, we'll flip it over and put the output panel in place and secure the corners with four screws and then each of the XLR jacks with two more screws. Now it's time to place the foam pad on the bottom of the case. Remove the backing, and if you have a heat gun, go ahead and heat it up a little bit to help you get a better application to the case. Be careful to line this up properly so that it's nice and even between each side, which we had a little difficult time doing. This is the completed L2P line level attenuator. And as you can see, it's got that nice little switch on the front from negative 10 to negative 30, two quarter inch inputs on one side, and two XLR outputs on the other side. We hope you enjoyed the video today learning how to make an L2P, and please like and subscribe for more content like this.